maybe 40 years back, when I was a student, I was in 8th grade in one of the best schools in my district. Being a bad performer, I was given a transfer certificate. They were 100% sure that I will not get, those days there is no A+, it was first class, 60%. So the school has got a standard that everybody will get 60%, and I was not a candidate for them. So they decided to throw me out. My teachers were really good in assessing me. I didn't get a first class in my SSLC or the 10th grade. 11th grade, I failed in all subjects, including mathematics. 4 marks out of 60, except in Malayalam, that's my language. 12th grade, again, I just got 52% passed. My brother was a professor. He told me that maybe I can take a BA Malayalam. I cannot study maths. I said, then I will take PhD in mathematics. Just because I wanted to challenge my brother, I took a PhD in mathematics. I became a scientist. But then I started changing not my life, the life of people around me. I started picking up the worst children. Wherever there are problems for anyone to study, I reach up to them and tell them this is the technique of learning. So I am a teacher who don't teach maths, physics, chemistry, biology, any of the subjects, but I teach how to learn. That's it. I don't train people to drive in one route. I will train them how to drive so that they can drive on any route. So that's what I am trying to share with you today. And it's a journey started long back. Unfortunately, I became a scientist in space department. But when I keep telling that I took retirement from Department of Space, I'm a space scientist, people glow their eyes and look at you. This is the man who's a scientist. Yeah, I have a look of a scientist. But then I was a policeman in Prime Minister's office under Director General of Security as a deputy director. They will again raise their eyebrow. But now I am teaching. When I say I'm a teacher, they will start grinning. It's, anybody can do it, right? Anybody can give teaching lessons, motivation, public speaking, yoga, and keep saying that you should think out of box. And I don't know where is the box and who has seen the box in this world, right? I'm a meditation master from Himalayas. I teach meditation, but I don't think I have taught anybody in this world meditation so far. But I have got a class called I'm a meditation master because my guru happens to be a meditation master and he is no more. So he asked me to teach, but I did not teach anyone so far. I never taught anybody mathematics. I never taught language to anyone. But I believe what I'm going to say is what is going to happen, right? Everyone who is a teacher, and traditionally in Bharatiya Shastra, we say, Atnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilidamyena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Anything you understood? Great, very good, yeah. Atnanam is not having knowledge, is like cataract. Everybody knows answer for most of the questions. But if you ask second, again look at them and ask the same question, they will start withdrawing, saying that I'm not that sure, but I know a little bit about it. Because it's like having a vision for a cataract patient. He can see, but he doesn't have a clear vision. Most of the people in this world pretend that they know, but if you start questioning, you will know that they don't know, right? That's what happens to most of the knowledge, so-called knowledgeable people so far with the certificates which we have. What we should do is we should raise their eyebrow and then give a kajal so that their vision becomes very clear. Atnana timirandasya, atnanam is not having knowledge is like a cataract, but give them a kajal and give them vision. They can learn anything in this world. This is what the traditional gurus did. Then you will become aham brahmasmi. Aham Brahmas means I am Brahma. Brahma is the god of creativity. If Brahma is with you, definitely Saraswati will come, because Brahma's wife is Saraswati. What happens is we have only Saraswati with us with a certificate, but Brahma will take Saraswati back because you are not creative. So being creative is learning. Thank you. And so only those people who are creative and have knowledge, or have knowledge and creativity, sustained in this world. Otherwise, like gas, they will come, say blah 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 and get out. That's it. And where do this Brahma remains? It's there by birth in all of us. Hridaya guhara madhye kevalam Brahma matram. Inside your hridaya, you open it up, you will see Brahma there. Life is creative, but we started talking about reactive. You have this problem, react like this. You have this problem, do like this. Don't do anything when you have problem. Keep quiet, sleep. That's what is to be done. Yeah. And who can talk about this? A person who is an acharya. Acharya is not one who gives lectures. You can look at him and say that, oh, I want to follow him. Look at him, not closely one day, 2 day, over a lecture. Look at him for his lifetime. Learn from Yadyada Jaradi Sreshta Tatta Devetarochara Sayat Pramanam Kurute Logastha Danuvartade. Looking at him, people must be able to follow him. Do you have such people in this world? Look at Vivekananda. I keep asking a question. Who is great, Vivekananda or Ramakrishna? Who is great, Vivekananda or Ramakrishna? Because Ramakrishna made Vivekananda? Only because of Vivekananda, Ramakrishna is famous. So who is great? Again, confusing. No answer from nobody in this world. I am sure even Vivekananda will not have an answer for this. But I am sure Vivekananda could not create many Vivekanandas. Therefore, Ramakrishna is great. Right? So creating good students is the master's job. We have a great guru, Kaudilya. Follow him. He made Chandragupta Maurya and a Maurya Samrajya to rule. We are all by birth. This is from my poetry, Life of Love. By birth, all of us raised millions of our unborn brothers and sisters before we took birth. The father's sperm get into the mother's egg, and only one sperm take birth, and that's me and that's you. How many of our unborn brothers and sisters died for us to live in this world? Millions. All of you raise your hand, take it back and say well done. At least for taking birth you must be happy, right? Don't look at the mirror and say that I don't look good. Keep saying this, I'm a winner in my life. So by birth all of us are good winners. Okay, this one book which made millions of people to interact with me, but not that way, the other way. Millions of people interacted with me and that became a book. This is a book which came out of Orkut, who is your today's Facebook's grandfather. Okay, I started interacting with my children from then, and lot of philosophical discussions happened. Most of my books are titled with the LIFA, life, because live in full enjoyment is life. You must enjoy every moment, create moments. You will only remember moments in your life if you are creative, not copy people, right? So try to be creative in your life. There is no try. Be creative in your life. And as a student, start learning in full enjoyment. Learning is a great investment for future earning. That's life for me. So try. Stop trying. Start doing from now onwards. You can do be very creative in research, very creative in photography, very creative in writing, creative in acting. Anything what you do, you can be highly creative. What stops you from this world for not being creative? Let us get back to what is stopping us. We don't have sankalpa. We don't have imagination. We don't visualize. Why? Because we were not taught how to visualize. How many of you have seen atoms in your life? Atom. All of you know what's an atom, but have you seen an atom? No. Shall I show you? Jalandaragade bhanav take a bucket of water, put a torchlight, you will see light going. There are particles moving inside that. In a dark room, a slit of light comes, particle moves in that. That particle you have seen? That's called a rajaha. Tasya trimshatamo bhagaha paramanu ridismradaha. Divide that into 30 pieces, you will get an atom. Is your imagination able to, your sankalpa is able to cut into 30 pieces? If not, one more line. Jnaninam drishti gocharaha. If you have buddhi, you will be able to divide it. Now I am sure all of you are able to visualize, right? So this sankalpa is what you should have. I am sure you are not visualized, right? I am sure I will take one example from a solitary reaper, one of the poetry book which most of you must have read in your classrooms, right? I don't know how many of you have this sankalpa of the poet when the teacher taught you. I remember teaching this when I passed my graduation. I didn't get any job, so I became a teacher those days. But I was a creative teacher. So I was teaching solitary reaper, saying that I go to the classroom and say, I am the Shakespeare and you are all the people. No, I am the William Wordsworth. I am the author. I am the Bernard Shaw when I take classes. That's how I do. I become the author. That's what I do. So when I teach solitary reaper, I will say, all my students, don't make noise, because there is a reaper who is singing and reaping by herself. Stop, don't disturb her. Now, are you able to visualize? Behold her, single in the field, yon solitary highland lass, singing and reaping by herself. If I just read that and explain, you are not able to visualize. If I just show you like a drama, therefore classroom have to be dramatics. I'm sure most of the children, one problem, I'm a psychotherapist. Most of the children come to me and say that, sir, I have no concentration. I said, wonderful, your brain is working. Why you are not able to have concentration? Do you go for a movie and you have 200% concentration there? Yes, when the heroine opens the door, you will see who is coming next, right? You are so curious. In your classroom, are you so curious to know what happens next? Why? Because your teachers are not able to make your class thrilling. Assume that you have got Shah Rukh Khan teaching you physics, Aishwarya Rai teaching you biology. I'm sure you will all glow your eyes and see that, oh, great, great class, right? Your class have to be more entertaining than educating. That's what life has to be. So don't learn by heart. That's what teacher says. I keep saying, learn by heart. So keep your manas open and start filling with lot of feelings in what you learn. Who can do this? Only when you have Shraddha, concentration. Lord Krishna, the greatest teacher in the world, who has got Sudarshana, great philosophy in his life, could not teach one student in the war field because he is going into the war. Similarly, all of you will read examination just before one day of the examination, nothing will go. And therefore Arjuna said, I am not able to follow. Krishna said, this will happen to all the people who are writing examination. Therefore, you have to do it with a lot of practice earlier. Shraddhavan labhate jnanam. Abhyasena tu kaundeya. Keep on practicing. Don't practice it one day before, right? Then you will have problem. So learn with full interest. I've seen 8 lakhs of students and 5 lakhs of teachers. Not seen. They suffered like this in my class, listening to me. Either you should suffer, because I am enjoying. So when somebody enjoys, others will suffer anyway, definitely, right? I've seen people who are learning. Everywhere there is only one problem, that they will say that my background is bad. So what? You cannot create a foreground or what? You start creating your foreground. The creative journey is very simple. It is 18 days of practice which you can change your life in learning style. Any subject you want. That's where I started teaching. And one of my first lecture, the creativity to the power of infinity, and the same title happened in Hyderabad with 1,200 BTech students. And I posted my PowerPoint presentation one day early. I asked all of you, prepare questions and then come to the hall. We had 500 questions. Sort it out and then started answering. At the end, somebody asked, sir, where is your PowerPoint? I said, that's creativity to the power of infinity, right? You don't create creative PowerPoints. You should start making powerful points. That's what we should do. There's my audience there. I had plenty of such audiences, where they learn. And one of the biggest program which changed my life is, because I was thrown out from an eighth grade, I picked up worst eighth grade children from Kerala, 90 of them, 45 girls and 45 boys who will never speak, why English, not even Malayalam. I picked up them, I want to teach them how to communicate in English, not in a American style or a British style, the pure Indian style. Okay, we don't have Indian style anyway, right? But then I took them to Goa. I asked my children, you are on the seashore, and you, when I was taking them in the train, out of 90, 66 of them were seeing train first time in their life. So you can imagine the background of the children. I took them to Goa, asked them to go to the seashore, find out some foreigner, get their geography, biology, history, everything from them. And there's few questions I asked them to write down. They wrote down, by hearted that, went and started asking question, asked, what's your name? Elizabeth, spelling please. Because they have to write down to give a report to me in the evening. And where are you from? Czech. They never heard Czech. Czech Republic. Which is the capital of Czech Republic? Which currency is there? Ask a lot of questions. This is how you gather knowledge. 3 days, they were not good in English, but they were courageous enough to talk to anybody in English. Right? They were not good in English, but courageous enough to talk to anybody in English. This is what my project is, Icon. You can have. These are the children. These are one of the clippings. And this is after 8 months, they changed their lifestyle. Right? And the another one, which I learned meditation, which I practice in my life, not half an hour every day, but 23 and a half an hour every day. Many meditators meditate half an hour, then the rest of the day struggle themselves, right? It should be the other way. You should meditate half the rest of your life, probably half an hour you can suffer in your life. Otherwise, what is the point in eating? Only while eating your stomach is full, as soon as you stop eating again, you are feeling hungry. For most of the people, meditation is a very stupid action, right? I do live. I go to Northeast where people have not even reached to touch a scientist. So when I go there, the children will come and they want to touch me. I said, why do you want to touch me? I want to go home and say, I touched a Indian space scientist. Look at the word which they use. Indian space scientist, because they themselves don't feel part of the country, because that's such an aloof place. I went to 17 to 18 schools there and taught more than 1,000 students in each year for last few years. They are brilliant children, but very less facility. These are all great part of this country where we can make small differences. And that small difference is much better than spending your time in some temple. Ena kena prakarena yasya kasyapi dehinaha sandosham janayat pratna tadevam ishvara pujanam. Creating happiness in somebody's face is much better than serving a god. That's what I learned from my gurus in Vedas. Right? I have got a program called, thank you, Shiksha Holiday Program, where I started giving lot of students motivation for being highly creative. This is what I wanted to tell you. Thank you. God bless you.